समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमावसदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्तु पुराणानामालिं करुणालिंगवान् भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यपुटं वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्याप्तविहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते नमः सहनावतु सहनं भुनक्तु सवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमारक्षापैः ॐ शान्तिः 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 यो ब्रह्माण्डातिपुरो वेदाक्षिपुण्योऽपि स्मृतो भव्यमात्ममुक्तिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वेशरणं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिः 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 नयान्तिक संसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दहनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपासुहे ది సూత్ర ఇంది అక్షరధ్యధికరణం అక్షరధి అధికరణం ఇచ్చి అక్షరధ్యాంతో అవరోధ సామాన్య తద్భావాభ్యాం ఓపసదవత్ తదుక్తం ఇది సాది సూత్రార్థ నవది వృత్తి అత్ర పూర్వపక్షే శ్రుతైః ఏవ నిషేధైః ఉపలక్షణతయా సర్వ నిషేధే సతి సతి సప్తం ఇదే సో వెన్ నిషేధ ఈజ్ పాసిబుల్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది గుణస్ బ్రహ్మ గుణస్ थ्रू आउट श्रुतिवाक्य इन दि स्व शाखांतर्गत श्रुतिवाक्य निषेधवाक्याज न इति न इति इन विच एवर फैशन इट इज डन बाय दैट अपवाद उपलक्षणतया सर्व निषेधे सति वेन सम गुणाज हैव बीन शोन एट नॉट बीइंग देयर इन ब्रह्म इन युअर ओन शाखा देन इट इज उपलक्षण फॉर अदर गुणाज ऑल्सो विच आर नॉट मेन्शन whether they are available in another shakha in the nisheda vakyas that is irrelevant because it is an upalakshana says the purvapakshi and thereby nirvishesha brahma pramito laghavam instead of looking through all the other shakha nisheda vakyas and then doing upasamhara in swashakha thereby understanding brahma instead of that you consider it as an upalakshana for all gunas and then just by few gunas being discussed as not being there in brahma you consider that all gunas are not there and thereby nirvishesha brahma pramiti jnana takes place and towards that jnana nirvishesha brahma pravito pramito laghavam there is laghavam it's a shortcut method This is what the Purvapakshi is saying. Siddhante tu upalakshane ekadesha parisheshau parityajya nirvishesha pramito nairakangshyam iti phalabhedaha. Siddhante says that this is not how Mimamsa works. You cannot take shortcuts in Mimamsa. So what you have to do is that you have to see whether upalakshana can be done ekadesha parisheshau All this you have to analyze. So Siddhanti to Upalakshana and Ekadesha Parishesha Parityajya. You have to give up both the Upalakshana and Ekadesha. So thereby Nirvishesha Pramito Nairakangsham iti Phalavedaha. There is Nirvishesha Brahma in the with respect to pramiti knowledge of nirvishesha brahma there is no akanksha at all so you cannot simply say that okay this is sufficient I will assume that I can extrapolate and then do upalakshana So all this upalakshana ekadesha parishesha tyaga cannot be done based on lack of information right now. You do not have such conclusive evidence as to upalakshana and ekadesha parishesha. Therefore, nairakyangsham says the siddhanti. What it means, we will see further. With example, Brihadaranyake Shruyate Etadvaitadaksharam Gari Brahmana Abhivadanti Astulam Ananu Ityadi So Astulam Ananu Some negations are seen as to Brahma is not Stula and it is not Anu सेज याज्ञवल्क्य टू गार्गी इन बृहत उपनिषद एतद् वही तद अक्षरम गार्गी हे गार्गी दिस इज दैट अक्षर ब्रह्म अक्षर विद्या सो अक्षरधि दिस ब्रह्म एतद् वही तद अक्षरम दैट ब्रह्म अक्षर दैट वी हैव हर्ड ऑफ इट इज दिस वेरी आत्मा एंड ब्राह्मणा अभिवदंती दिस इज व्हाट ब्राह्मणास टॉक अबाउट इंटरेस्टिंगली इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी हैव सीन अर्लियर ऑल्सो गार्गी हैज आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन विच इज अ उभयपाश रज्जु दिस निर्गुण विच कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट निर्गुण देन इट इज अ दोष एंड इफ यू डू नॉट टॉक अबाउट इट देन द क्वेश्चन हैज नॉट बीन आंसर्ड देयर फॉर यू हैव लॉस्ट द इन द सभा दिस इज हाउ गार्गी पोजेस द क्वेश्चन सो वॉट भगवान याज्ञवल्क्य डज ही हैज गॉट अ वेरी गुड वे आउट सो ही डज नॉट टेक ईदर ऑफ द ऑप्शंस He does not say that I am saying that this is what Brahma is with regard to the question of Brahma. And he does not even say that I won't answer. He does not stop answering. So he answers the question and he avoids the pitfall by saying that Brahmana Abhivadanti. This is what Brahmanas, those who know Brahma Janati iti Brahmana or Jananti iti Brahmana, those Brahmanas who know Brahma, they talk about in this manner. Therefore, he has avoided the trap of Shabdata talking about Brahma, which may be considered as a dosha, the way Gargi has posed the question. And he has answered the question, therefore, he is still in the Vidvat Sabha. So, Brahmana Abhivadanti, what is this Akshara Brahma that they talk about, that very Akshara Brahma is this Atma which is talked about by Brahmana as what? Astul and Anarhu. It is not stula, it is not anu. So, neti neti prakriya is taught. This is the only way to understand Brahmatma, evam atharvane. Whereas in Mundaka Upanishad of Atharvana Veda, Atharva Veda, Aksharam Upakramya, having begun with Akshara Brahma, Yattaradreshyam Agrahyam Ityadi. So, having talked about Akshara Brahma, further what is said? That very Brahma Akshara which has been discussed in the opening statement, Tad Adreshyam Agrahyam, there also negation is there. It is not that which can be grasped by Indriyas, Jnana Indriyas as well as Karma Indriyas, there is Nisheda done. Ityadi, therefore, Nisheda Shruti is there in मल्टीपल उपनिषद्स तत्र किं क्वचिन् निषेधश्रुतौ अश्रुतनिषेधानां श्रुत्यन्तरात् उपसंहार अस्ति न वा इति संदेहे सति नास्ति इति पूर्वपक्ष पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट व्हेन देयर इज अ डाउट एज टू वेदर यू हैव टू डू गुण उपसंहार ऑफ निषेध श्रुतिस फ्रॉम अनदर उपनिषद इनटू स्वशाखा और नॉट एंड वाइस वर्सा सो क्वचित् निषेधश्रुतौ समवेयर निषेधा इज हर्ड इन युअर शाखा अश्रुतनिषेधानां दोष Nisheda which have not been heard in your shaka, they are heard elsewhere in another shaka, whether you should bring them together or not. Purvapakshi says no, but Siddhanti says, Siddhantastu, what is Siddhanta? Akshare Brahmani Dvaita Nisheda Dhiyaha Akshara Dhiyaha. The Dvaita Nisheda Dhiya, the buddhis of Dvaita Nisheda, which is actually with respect to Akshara Brahma. In Akshara Brahma, in this Naksharati iti aksharam Brahma which does not have any Kshaya also that kind of a Brahma has no gunas which kind of gunas no such gunas dvaita gunas are all bringing dvaita so dvaita nisheda buddhi is what akshara buddhi if you do nisheda then what you cannot negate is Brahma This is the process. So some gunas have been negated, which have been discussed in the shakha in the opening, swashakha, and then whatever are in the adhyaropasthana, those gunas are negated in the apavadasthana. So tasam sarvatra nisheda shrutishu avarodaha upasamhara nyayaha. Avaroda is upasamhara here in that meaning. So you have to club together all the निषेध वाक्यास टुगेदर विथ एक वाक्यता वेदर दे आर इन योर शाखा और अदर शाखा टू अंडरस्टैंड ब्रह्म प्रॉपरली कुतः वाई सो इफ द पूर्व पक्षी वेर टू आ सिद्धांति से सामान्य सामान्य तद्भावाभ्याम सो मूला इज श्रुति इज सॉरी सूत्र इज सामान्य तद्भावाभ्याम सामान्य इज वॉट दिस ब्रह्म विच इज प्रतिपादित दैट ब्रह्म इज द गोल इन अनदर शाखा ऑल्सो अनदर उपनिषद विच इज अनदर शाखा अंतर्गत उपनिषद इन दैट वेदांत शास्त्र ऑल्सो द सेम ब्रह्म विच इज डिस्कस इन द स्वशाखा is being revealed therefore samanya is there between that shakha and your shakha specifically the nisheda vakyas then tadbhavabhyam means brahma bhava the way this brahma is taught here in the same manner the resultant brahma is there in the other shakha also the ekatva is pratipadita ek oneness is revealed between atma and brahma in your shakha also and in the other shakhas also therefore tadbhava brahma bhava which is ekatva is taught elsewhere also therefore dvaita nirasena brahma pratipadanasya sarvatra samanyam samanatvam tasya brahmana pratipadyasya sarvatra bhavah ekatvena pratyabhijnayamanatvam You see that this Brahma which is discussed there with Ekata, this Ekameva Advitiya Brahma in your Shaka as well as another Shaka with various words of course, that is what you land on after Nisheda. So after some gunas which have been discussed in the opening in your Shaka, having negated those, what you are left with is Brahma, Nirguna Brahma and in another Shaka also, whatever gunas are discussed in the Adhyaropa in the opening, In Apavada, Nisheda Vakyas, what you land up with is the same Brahma. Therefore, there is Pratyabhijna of this very Brahma being discussed there also. So, the Brahma is the goal. So, Samanya is there, Samanatva, across Shakhas. And there is a Pratyabhijna of this very Brahma, which is Ekameva Advitiya in so many words or in different words. Thereby, Brahma Bhava is also Ekatvena. प्रत्यभिज्ञाय मानत्वम् सो एकत्वेन प्रति प्रत्यभिज्ञाय इज देयर प्रत्यभिज्ञान टेक्स प्लेस देयरफॉर द्वैत निरासेन ब्रह्म प्रतिपादनस्य सर्वत्र सामान्यम समानत्वम् इज देयर थ्रू दिस निषेध द्वैत निरास व्हाट यू लैंड ऑन इज ब्रह्म दैट ब्रह्म इज रिवील्ड इन बोथ शाखास एंड दैट रिवीलेशन सर्वत्र इज समान इट इज वन एंड द सेम Then tasya bhava, tadbhava is brahmana bhava, brahma bhava is also discussed there for atma. So pratipadyasya sarvatra, this brahma which is revealed there is one and the same. It is not that in one shaka saguna brahma is revealed and in another shaka nirguna brahma. Or it is not that in one shaka there is ausha aushi bhava discussed and in another shaka there is ekatva discussed. It is not so. So the brahma, the way It is revealed, may be different, but the Brahma which is revealed, there is Pratyabhijna regarding this Ekatvena. It is one and the same Brahma which is discussed, it is Nirguna Brahma itself, Tabhyam Hetubhyam Ityartha. These become the two Hetus whereby Guna Upasamhara Avarodha should be done for Aksharadhi of Brahma Buddhi. For Brahma Buddhi, this Nisheda Vakya from Various shakhas, Upanishad should be brought together into swashakha also. What is the example there? So, opasada vata, the opasada homa, there also you have this clubbing together. Even if it is in another shruti, even in another Veda also, you have to club it together because sambandha is known. By the sambandha, it has to be joined in swashakha. Taduktam. This is how it has been dealt with in the Purva Mimamsa Sutra and therefore Uttara Mimamsa should also follow similar analysis. Tatra Drashtanta Aupasadavata. So Aupasadav Homavata. यथा जामदग्ने अहिने पुरोडाशिनीषु उपसत्सु चोदितानां औपसदानां अध्वर्यु कर्तृक पुरोडाश शेषाणां मंत्राणां यत्र क्वचित् श्रुतानां अपि अध्वर्यूणां संबंधः. सो अध्वर्यु इज द वन हु इज फॉलोइंग यजुर्वेद शाखा. यजुर्वेद शाखा मीनिंग ही इज द वन हु इज डूइंग एक्चुअल होम. एंड साम वेद शाखा फॉलोअर्स साम वेदीज आर चैंटिंग दे आर डूइंग उपगान उद्गान मंत्रास आर बीइंग चैंटेड विथ साम स्वराज बाय देम. नाउ देर इन अहीन देर इज अ पर्टिक्युलर अहीन इष्टी. सो देर इष्टी विच इज डन इन अक्रॉस फोर नाइट्स. सो जामदग्नि अहिनी अहीन दैट याग इज डन अक्रॉस फोर नाइट्स. सो पुरोडाशिनीषु उपसत्सु चोदितानां औपसदानां औपसदानां दिस औपसद मंत्रास इन द इष्टि दीज मंत्रास विच आर रेड इन दैट पर्टिक्युलर इष्टि दि इष्टि याग सोमयाग पशु याग दीज आर थ्री यागास वेर उपसद इज दैट इष्टि. एंड इन दैट याग दि मंत्र विच इज रेड उपसदे भव मंत्र औपसद. सो औपसद मंत्र उपसद इज अ मंत्र विच इज यूज इन दि उपसद याग. सो दिस उपसद इष्टि याग. सो देर दिस चोदितानां औपसदानां दीज मंत्रास विच आर गिवन एज अ विधि वेर वेर डू यू फाइंड दैट दि अध्वर्यु कर्तृक पुरोडाश शेषाणां दि पुरोडाश. In that Purodashi Yaga, what you are doing there, the when you go through that section, you see this Adhvaryu Kartruka Purodasha Sheshanam. So Purodasha is made by the Adhvaryu. The Purodasha in the Yaga, there that Purodasha is made by Adhvaryu. So Adhvaryu is making that, and that Shesha of that is the mantra. Purodasha Sheshanam. Mantranam. These mantras, which mantras? The Aupasada mantras. Aupasada mantras, although they find themselves elsewhere, meaning in Samaveda also, but they are Vakyashesha. They are not Vakyashesha, they are Karmashesha to Purodasha. While Purodasha is being made and being offered there, this mantra has to be chanted, Aupasada mantra. Therefore, even if these mantras yatra kochit shrutanam api adhvaryunam sambandha, even if they are not heard in the yajushaka, they are heard in the samashaka. Yatra kochit, let them be there in samashaka or anywhere else, but still they have sambandha with adhvaryu. Let them be in the swashaka also, but elsewhere, but they are to be chanted by adhvaryu, they have sambandha with adhvaryu. Therefore तथा अक्षर प्रमित शेषाणां निषेधानां यत्र क्वचित् श्रुतानामपि अक्षरेण सर्वत्र संबंध इत्यर्थः. देयरफॉर दिस अक्षर प्रमिति अक्षर ब्रह्म प्रमिति शेषाणां टू अंडरस्टैंड ब्रह्म यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड अपवाद ऑफ ऑल दि अध्यारोपित गुणास वेदर दे आर इन योर शाखा और एल्सवेयर. Therefore, the Nisheda which is done in other Shrutis also, they have to be taken into account. You cannot just assume that all Gunas are not there without analysis. Of course, after analysis and understanding, if you see one mantra, then it will bring the memory of others also. You will understand what is the conclusion. Therefore, you can use an Upalakshana for your own Manana, you can use. But this Upalakshana cannot be when you are analyzing Swashaka and you have not reached the conclusion yet. During the analysis, you have to follow the process. After the analysis and conclusion, you can use all sorts of shortcut methods. There are no laghavas in analysis. Analysis should be done completely and you land on the meaning as to Brahma is Nirguna, how it does not have these gunas which are in Swashaka and it does not have other gunas which are in other shakhas also. So क्वचित् श्रुतानाम् अपि अक्षरेण सर्वत्र सम्बन्धः इत्यर्थः. दे आर् आल् कनेक्टेड् वित् अक्षर ब्रह्म एज़् हेविङ्ग् नो कनेक्शन् इन् दि अध्यारोप कनेक्शन् हेज़् बीन् मेड् बिकास् इट् इस् अनुवाद we take it for granted. Therefore, Shruti talks about this, whether it is related to Jivatma or Brahmatma, based on the Vyashti and Samashti Bheda, all gunas are discussed because they are accepted beforehand, finding oneself in samsara. On the part of the Jiva, there is acceptance of Jiva gunas before the Shruti starts teaching. Therefore, it does hand-holding by saying, okay, yes, there is some value, they have Vyavaharika Satta, and so on. And since this person is a samsari, he sees samsara as separate from oneself, therefore, Shruti also talks about Srishtikarta, Ishvara, because there is akanksha of who created this prapancha. Therefore, there also there is an anuvada, which is adhyaropasthaniya at the samashti level. Then slowly there is apuvada done across both vyashti and samashti, and these are done in various Upanishads differently by various prakriyas. So adhyaropa and apuvada is there in multiple shrutis. Gunas are talked, which are different from each other across shrutis. All those are to be clubbed together in Adhyaropa also, and then in Apavada also. In Adhyaropa meaning to understand which are these gunas where you have Nisheda being done, with respect to which you have Nisheda being done. Therefore, Nisheda mantras are connected with Akshara, because Akshara Jnana won't take place, Akshara Brahma Jnana, Jnana won't take place without such negation. Therefore, Nisheda Shrutis everywhere have sambandha with Akshara Brahma, which is in Swashaka. Sarvatra sambandha aksharena brahmana saha, swashakha antargata aksharena brahmana saha api sarvatra sarva shrutishu sambandha ityartha nisheda vakya nisheda vakyanam sambandha ityartha taduktam jaiminina. And in prathame kande, in the first chapter, first kanda in Purvamimamsa, this is mentioned by Jaimini Maharshi as to guna mukhya vyatikrame tadarthatvan mukhyena veda sanyoga iti. And that is mentioned as to the balavattara mukhya. With the mukhya there is samprayoga, sanyoga, veda sanyoga, there is a sambandha. So guna mukhya vyatikrame, when there is a guna and mukhya. Guna is gauna, secondary. Mukhya is primary. So there, when there is a virodha between guna and mukhya, when there is virodha like that, then vyatikrami. When there is a virodha, vyatikrami sati, virode sati, kim karaniyam tadarthatvat. So tadarthatvat veda sanyoga, you have to make the connection there. Balavattara mukhya, primary, with the primary there will be guna sambandha. So this is the in the Utpatti Vinyoga, such kind of an analysis is done, and we are doing the same thing in Uttara Mimamsa, says the Siddhanti. Thereby this Adhikarana is over. The next Adhikarana introduction is Purvam Vedyasya Aksharasya Aikye Vidya Ikyat Akshara Vidhyam Upasamhara Uktaha. What has the Siddhanti done? He has stated and concluded that there is Upasamhara of the gunas, of Nisheda gunas, in another Shruti also. For what purpose? Unto, with respect to this Akshara Dhi, Akshara Brahma Buddhi Jnana, for that you have to do this. So with respect to that, or Vishay, what have to do? You have to do Upasamhara of the Nisheda gunas, Guna Nishedas, done in another Shruti also, across Shrutis. And how is this established? Vedyasya aksharasya aikye vidyaikya, vidyaikyam tasmad hetu. So Vedya Brahma is same across Shrutis. So this Akshara Brahma is Vedya in your shakha also, in another shakha also. Therefore Vidya also is one. If the Vedya is one, Vidya which is having a different prakriya also, the Vidya is still one. Therefore, Jnana being one, you have landed on Upasamhara of the Nisheda Shrutis across Shakhas. Tarhi iha dvasuparna iti vakye ekasya eva bhoktrutvam rutam pibanto iti vakye ubhayorapi iti उभयत्र वेद्य भेदाद विद्या भेदा इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या नमः. पूर्व पक्षी गिव्स अ काउंटर एग्जांपल टू दिस सेइंग दैट देयर आर दीज मंत्रास एज टू द्वासुपर्ण ऋतम पिबंतु इत्यादि ऑल दीज मंत्रास आर हर्ड. सो वेयर यू हियर दिस मंत्र इन मुंडक एंड दे दिस ऋतम पिबंतु इन कठोपनिषद. सो द्वासुपर्ण देयर आर दीज टू बर्ड्स. One is, so this is a simile. One bird is eating and the other is watching. So iti vakye ekasya bhoktrutvam. So one bird is eating and the other higher placed bird is watching over this bird which is eating. And the simile is used to explain Paramatma is abhokta, he is sitting as a sakshi, whereas this jiva is a bhokta, karma phala bhokta. So the jiva is eating karma phala like the bird is eating a fruit. That is the simile there, through which what is explained, this Paramatma, Shuddha Brahma, is separate from Jivatma, who is a sakshi, whereas Jivatma, the latter, is bhokta. So ekasyeva bhoktrutvam, only jiva is bhokta, Jivatma, whereas Paramatma is abhokta. This has been mentioned. Now in another Shruti across Shakhas, Kata Shakha, what do you see? Rutam Pibanto. So Rutam is Karma Phala and Pibanto is in dual. Those who are partaking this Karma Phala. So both are Bhoktas, Jiva and Paramatma, both are said to be Bhoktas here. There is no Sakshi and Bhokta difference. There is Bhokta and Bhokta Aikya. सो इति वाक्ये उभयोरपि इति उभयत्र उभयोरपि किं भोक्तृत्वम् इन दि मांडुक्य श्रुति सॉरी मुंडक श्रुति एकस्यैव भोक्तृत्वम् वेयर एज इन कट श्रुति उभयोरपि भोक्तृत्वम् देयर बाय देयर इज डिफरेंस इन वेद्य उभयत्र वेद्य भेदात. This what has to be known is that Jiva and Paramatma are to be known in both cases, but in one case Jiva is to be known as Bhokta, in another case Jiva and Paramatma both are to be known as Bhokta, says the Purvapakshi. Therefore there is Vedya Bhokta Bheda, Bhoktas are different, and therefore Vidya Bheda also, Jnana which is given in Mundaka is different from that which is given in Katha and vice versa. Therefore Vidya Bhedaha, Vidya Yoho Bheda, between the Vidyas there is Bheda. Iti Pratyudharana Sangatya Idamaha. There is a counter example brought up by the Purvapakshi as per his understanding of Mundaka and Katha, which is not the correct interpretation. Thereby Yadhadikaranam comes up. Iyat means this much. So Kiyat, how much? So their answer is given Iyat, this much. Meaning Dvitva. There are two. Who among them is the Bhokta? That discussion follows later. But in both cases, there are two. In Mundaka also, the simile is of the two birds landing into exemplified Brahma and Atma, Paramatma and Atma, Jivatma. And in the Katha Shruti also, Rutam Pibanto is a Dvivachana anyway. So, Dvitva Sankhya Bodhaka is there in Katha also, where Atma and Jivatma and Paramatma are two discussed there. Later there is Aikya, that is the Prakriya, but then initially it starts with talking about two. In both cases it is said when there is Ajnana, then one considers oneself as a Bhokta and Paramatma is Sakshi. But in Jnana Avastha one knows that one is also not associated with Bhoga. In Mundaka this is the process used, and then in when one knows that I am not really this Bhokta, I am somehow associated, and therefore I consider myself different and from Paramatma, but really I am Paramatma. Once this Jnana takes place, then he does not see himself as separate from that Paramatma who is watching over, but he has Sakshi Bhava and he is the one who is watching over the Antakkarana Ityadi, which is having this Bhokta Vritti etc. Bhoktavritti. Whereas in Rutam Pibanto, Katha Upanishad, there both are partaking is mentioned. This is also Ajnana. And then Aikya is discussed in a different manner there. But you land on Aikya there. Now, therefore, Iyat. Iyat meaning Dvitva Sankhya Bodhaka is there in both cases. And this is how Bhagavan Sutrakara says, Iyadamananat. So, Iyat. Vidya is one. This is the Hetu. Iyadamananat. Because Dvitva Sankhya is used in both cases. And if you go through how both Jiva and Paramatma are dealt with, although the opening is different, the conclusion is the same. Therefore, starting with that Dvitva Vidya is one, landing on Advitiya Brahma, Brahmatma. So, Yatta Parichinna Vedya, the Vedya that you think is in one case, it is one Bhokta, other Abhokta, and in the second case, both Bhoktas, that kind of an understanding is erroneous. What Siddhanti says is, you look at how the Mimamsa has to be done. So, this Dvitva Sankhya Parichinna, Yat Parichinna, Yatta Parichinna, Brahma, this Dvitva Sankhya Parichinna Brahma is one. So, Upadhi is being taken into account. This Bhoktrutva Upadhi Ityadi, that varies in details, but then the Dvitva Sankhya, which is in the Adhyaropasthana, that is same. With the Upadhi, there is Bheda considered, and the Upadhi details vary. But the Upadhi as to, with the Jiva Upadhi, Paramatma becomes Bhokta. Without this Upadhi, Paramatma remains Sakshi. This kind of process is being used. Therefore, the Sankhya Bodhaka Iyatta, that is same in both cases. So, that is the Sutrartha there as to Iyad Amananat, meaning Iyataha Amananat. This is Shashti, Tatpurusha, single word, Asamasa. Iyataha meaning Ubhayatra, Dvitva Sankhya Avachinnasya, Dvitva Avachinnasya, Ekasyeva Amananat. So, when you remove the Upadhi, Dvitva Sankhya is the Upadhi in both cases. When you remove it, what remains is Shuddha Brahma, Paramatma, which is not different from Jivatma. Therefore, the process being used, in details it may vary, but this landing from the Adhyaropita Dvitva and Apavadasthana Shuddha Brahma being one and the same, the revealed Brahma finally is Ekameva Dvitiya. Therefore, the Pratipadita Vishaya is also one, and there is Ekatva in Pratyabhijna also between the Brahma which is revealed in Mundaka as well as the Brahma which is finally revealed in Kathopanishad. That is the Sutrartha. Patra Purvapakshe Vidya Bhedad Anyonyam Guna Anupasamhara. Guna Anupasamhara. Guna should not be clubbed together between Katha and Mundaka. Why? Because there is Vidya Bheda. So mutually they should not be club together across each other. Why? There is difference in Vidya. Siddhante Tarabhedad Upasamharaiti Phalabheda. Siddhanti says that no, there is Abheda between Vidya in Katha and across to Mundaka and vice versa. Therefore, Guna Upasamhara should be done. They are one and the same Vidya. For Jnana, you study both. You study Mundaka also, Katha also, and do the Upasamhara, understand with both prakriyas as to how this Brahma is revealed as your very Swarupa. Atharvane Dvasuparna Sayuja Ityadi Mantraha Shruyate. In Mundaka, you have this mantra. Two birds are there. They are sitting on a, perching on a tree together. Kathake Api Rutam Pibantu Ityadi. And there are two who are partaking of karma phala, says Kata Shruti, Kata Upanishad. Tatra kim anayur mantrayor vidyabheda uta abheda iti vishaye, when there is a samshaya whether these two vidyas are different, vidyabheda iti purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says that there is difference in vidyas across both shrutis. Siddhanta is mantra dvaya vidyaya abheda eva. Even if there are two different types of mantras as seen in Katha and Mundaka, देर इज डेफिनेटली अभेद इन विद्यास कुतः हाउ सो वाई सो यतः सो यद आमनुनात इज यतः आमनुनात षष्ठी तत्पुरुष सो यतः मीनिंग यत्तावच्छिन्नस्य द्वित्वावच्छिन्नस्य उभयत्र अपि अभिन्नत्वेन आमनुनात अभिधाना द्वितीयतः आमनुनात मीन्स श्रुति वाक्या इज लाइक दैट इट लीड्स टू द सेम कंक्लूजन सो व्हाट इज बीइंग रिवील्ड What is the Shruti stating really? The narration in the Shruti is of that Brahmatma which is Abhinna Ubhayatrapi. In both Shakas, Katha and Mundaka Shaka, both it is one and the same. Through what? This Dvitva Avachinnatvam. And then taking away that Dvitva Avachinnatvam, the upadhi is taken away, visheshanas are taken away, upadhi is taken away, what remains is shuddha brahma, therefore yattavachinnasya brahmanaha, that brahma which is as though delimited by dvitva sankhya, jiva and paramatma, that is taken away, dvitvavachinna, it is taken away later and then ubhayatrapi abhinnatvena amananath, what is revealed in both cases is that shuddha brahma which is free from dvitva sankhya, There is no Jivatma, Paramatma, Bheda at all. That is the narration, revelation in both Katha and Mundaka. Atrahi mantra dvaye bhoktrutva anuvadena Paramatma Bheda Pratipadya. So process varies in detail, definitely. But the conclusion is the same. And it starts with Dvitva Sankhya as the delimiting factor in both cases. So you have Upakrama and Upasamhara, Aikya. In both cases. So, mantra dvaye bhoktrutva anuvadena paramatma abheda pratipadya. Bheda also and abheda also can be seen through the angle of bhoktrutva being there or not being there. So, mantra dvaye bhoktrutva anuvada is being done. There is a bhoktrutva anuvada. You consider that jiva is bhokta. So, Shruti says yes, jiva is bhokta. Starts there. Pibanta viti prayogastu. What about the other case? In the case of Mundaka, Jiva alone is said to be Bhokta. So there is an anuvada. Therefore, Paramatma abheda pratipadya through that. By saying anuvada, oh you consider yourself Bhokta, okay, you are a Bhokta. Then it takes away that Bhoktrutva and Mundaka shows that you are not different from Paramatma who is a Bhokta. पिबंतौ इति प्रयोगस्तु भोक्तृजीव सहचर्यात् अभोक्त अभोक्तरी ईश्वरे क्षत्रिणो गच्छन्ति इतिवत् उपपद्यते इति अवरोधः सो दिस सॉरी इति अविरोधः सो देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन बिटवीन कठ एंड मुंडक व्हाई बिकॉज इन कठ आल्सो व्हेन यू से पिबंतौ शोज भोक्तृत्व बाय पाधातु पाधातु इज टू ड्रिंक To partake. So karma phala bhoga is seen with the literal meaning of pibantau in both cases. In both cases meaning in the case of jivatma and paramatma as read in Katha Shruti. So there that prayoga where dual has been used, how does it not mean that both are bhoktas, the Purva Pakshi? To that the Siddhanti says due to this proximity of antakkarana, This Jiva and Paramatma Bheda is not known. And therefore, Jiva who is having Bhokta, Jiva who is considering himself as Bhokta is having Bhoga. He considers that Paramatma is also having Bhoga. So, like Chhatri, Chhatri Nyaya. Chhatri Nyaya is those who are carrying umbrellas. Not everyone is carrying an umbrella. Some may be wearing a raincoat, some may be not wearing a raincoat and not carrying an umbrella also, but then when you see, you don't know that it is raining, and when you see out of your window, you see many people are carrying umbrella, so you say, look at them, chhatrinah gacchanti, those who are carrying umbrellas are going, or it may not be even raining, but you see a group carrying umbrellas due to, you know, for protecting from heat or whatever, but when you look at them, you see people carrying umbrella, so it is not that everyone is carrying an umbrella, but you call the other and say, look at them, you know, these people who are carrying umbrellas are going, chhatrinah gacchanti. It is not that everyone is carrying an umbrella, so the other person can point out, look at that, where is everyone carrying an umbrella? So many are carrying an umbrella. Similarly here, you are associated with the Jiva Bhava. So you are carrying an umbrella of this Bhoktrutva. So Bhoktrutva Bhava is in you. You the Jiva. Therefore, the usage by the Shruti is saying that Vibhantau does not mean that both are Bhoktas. It is just saying that one is a Bhokta, the other appears to be Bhokta in proximity, and such usage is allowed there. So Bhoktru Jiva Sahacharyat, because Paramatma is Sahachari with Bhokta Jiva, Abhoktari Ishwari also. Unto this Abhokta Paramatma Ishwara Chatrina Gacchanti Iti Vad. Based on that Nyaya, like that Nyaya, there is Prayoga of Pibantu, that dual Dvivachana is not literal. Iti Vad Upapadyate Iti Avirodha. So it can be explained how Pibantu usage has been done. It is a misunderstanding, but it is not in the literal sense. Just like all of them, look at them, all these people who are carrying the umbrellas, not all are carrying umbrellas. So that is the Sutra as well as the Adhikarana. Now the next Adhikarana is Antaratva Adhikarana. It is introduced by saying Puram Pibantau Ityasya Padasya Lakshanikatvena Vedya Ikyad Vidyaikya Vidyaikyam Abhani. So what was done by the Siddhanti, says the Purvapakshi, is that this Pibantau, earlier Pibantau, this word has been used in Dvivachana Ityasya Padasya Lakshanikatvina. By Lakshana it will land on only Jiva who is Bhokta, who is Piban, but not the Paramatma, Brahmatma. Tattva is free, it is always a Sakshi. Therefore Lakshana has been Lakshanikatvina Vedya Ikya. Therefore Vedya Brahma is one and the same in both cases. This is how you had explained Vidya Ikyam. Across Mundaka as well as Katha, there is single Vidya. इहतु वेद्या भेदे अपि न विद्या भेदः. सो पूर्वपक्षी इज ब्रिंगिंग अ काउंटर एग्जांपल प्रत्युदाहरण संगति एज टू व्हाट देयर इज विद्या भेद ऑल्दो देयर इज वेद्य भेद. ऑल्दो वेद्य इज वन एंड द सेम, दैट विच हैज टू बी नोन इज वन एंड द सेम, बट स्टिल देयर इज भेद इन विद्या. इन अ पर्टिकुलर केस दैट ही विल ब्रिंग अप, Atma is being discussed in two different Vakyas. Now there is Atma, which the word Atma or literally, or that which stands for Atma, Paramatma, Brahma Shabda. So there is a Prayoga across Vakyas where Atma is being talked about and Atma is being repeated. Any repetition literally in Shruti meaning the same thing has a Vakya Dosha, has a Punarukti Dosha, not Vakya Dosha, Punarukti Dosha. To avoid Punarukti Dosha, what is done in Purva Mimamsa, Mimamsa and Uttar Mimamsa also, the Shabdata repetition is interpreted differently. Of course, in Vedanta it is allowed, we say that because the Jnana cannot take place in Sukshma Amsha, if the very subtle matter cannot be understood by a single methodology or single utterance also, it has to be uttered multiple times. So even if it has the same meaning in Vedanta, we don't really consider it as a dosha. But yes, it has been taken in different contexts or with different introduction or sangati. Same mantra, shabdata, same phrase is explained differently. Meaning is same, but the context set is different, the akanksha set is different, the question inquiry is different. So in Vedanta there are different ways to resolve this. But since it is a Mimamsa, Purva Mimamsa and Uttar Mimamsa processes should be similar. If there is a Punarukti Dosha in the repetition in Purva Mimamsa, same should be considered in Uttar Mimamsa, and this is the process followed by the Purva Pakshi, who says that Samido Yajati Ityadav Yajati Abhyasavat. This Yajati Shabda as to Yaga is done. Yaga is to be done. It's a Vidhi, Latlakara, but considered as a Vidhi. Because Yajati समिदो यजति. सो दिस समिति इज यूज इन याग. इज समित दी ओनली थिंग विच इज यूज? नो. समिधो यजति, तनून पातं यजति, इडो यजति, बर्हिर यजति, स्वाहाकारं यजति. देर आर दीज इति पंचयाग प्रयाजे भिन्ना. इन प्रयाज देर आर दीज फाइव यागास. सो समित एटसेट्रा, इडह, बर्हि, स्वाहाकार, ऑल दीज देर आर फाइव डिफरेंट यागास वेर यजति शब्द इज रिपीटेड. यजति शब्द इज रिपीटेड शब्द था यजति यजति यजति. बट इवन देन इत्यादो यजति अभ्यासवत. ऑल्दो यजत व्हेन यजति इज रिपीटेड देर आर डिफरेंट यागास. दे आर नॉट फाइव सेम यागास. इट इज नॉट दैट यू ऑफर ऑल द फाइव इन वन सिंगल यागा. दे आर फाइव डिफरेंट यागास. सो यजति अभ्यास सिंस यू वॉन्ट टू डिफरेंशिएट वन यजति फ्रॉम द अदर यजति इन फाइव रिपीटेशंस देर यू हैव टू टेक देम एज फाइव डिफरेंट यागास. सो कर्म भेद टेक्स प्लेस. सिमिलरली हियर आत्मा बीइंग रिपीटेड देर विल बी विद्या भेद. दैट आत्मा विच इज डिस्कस्ड इन द फर्स्ट केस एंड इन द सेकेंड केस दे आर डिफरेंट. दे हैव टू बी डिफरेंट विद्यास. सो वेद्य अभेद अपि ऑल्दो यू से इट्स द सेम आत्मा विच इज डिस्कस्ड बट स्टिल विद्या गिवन ज्ञान इज डिफरेंट. दिस इज हाउ द पूर्व पक्षी गिव्स अ काउंटर एग्जाम्पल. सो आत्मा अभ्यासाद इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्य इदमाह. हाउ यजति अभ्यासवत. जस्ट लाइक यजति अभ्यास देर इज आत्मा अभ्यास एंड देर बाय दिस इज अ काउंटर एग्जाम्पल टू विद्याभेद बिकॉज ऑफ वेद्य अभेद. सॉरी विद्या अभेद बिकॉज ऑफ वेद्य अभेद. बट हियर इट इज नॉट सो. हियर वेद्याभेद इज देर बट देर इज नो विद्या अभेद. देर इज विद्याभेद एंड देर बाय अंतरत्वाधिकरण कम्स अप. आई स्टॉप विद द सूत्र. अंतराभूतग्रामवत् स्वात्मनः. अंतराभूतग्रामवत् स्वात्मनः. सो सूत्र सेज अंतराभूतग्रामवत् स्वात्मनः. सो स्वात्मनः अंतरा आमनन्ता. सो आमनना दिस आमननात हैज अनुवृत्ति हियर एज पर द सिद्धांति. सो सूत्रकार सेज दिस आमननात यू ब्रिंग हियर. सो स्वात्मनः अंतरा आमननात मीनिंग आत्मा हैज बीन स्वात्मा has been revealed in the Shruti as what? Antara. Swatmanah Antara Amananat. It is being stated as being very, the innermost. Sarvantaratvin. Atmana Ekatvat. Amananat. Amananat is Ekatvin Amananat. Vidyayaha Ekatvam. Therefore, because of this Atma, one's own Swarupa being discussed as the Swarupa of every being, Antara, the innermost Pratyagatma, therefore the Vidya Ekatva is there, Amananat. Since that kind of oneness is revealed across Shrutis, therefore Vidya Ekya also, Vedya Atma which is discussed as innermost for everyone, across Shrutis, that is common. Therefore, the revelation of the revealed being one, the Vidya, which is the process in which the revelation takes place, that Vidya finally conclusive is one and the same. How? Bhutagramavat. Bhutagramavat. So, this innermost thing, one being interior to the other is Apekshika Antaratvam. We'll see what the objection of the Purvapakshi is. We'll see more in the Vritti in the next part. Huh? But here this Bhuta Grama Vat. Grama is Samuha. Of what Bhuta? Bhuta Naam Grama. So Grama there is collection of Bhutas. Bhutas are Pancha Mahabhuta. So Pancha Mahabhuta Antaravat. Like this Apekshika Antaratvam. Or Sarva Bhuteshu Devavat Ekatvam. So we'll see how this example works in the next part. Huh? The current understanding, for current understanding, this is sufficient as to in Mahabhutas also we see that when Prithvi is being discussed, interior to Prithvi is what? Interior to Prithvi is Jala. Interior to Jala is vanni, then vayu, akasha. So what you finally land on is the this comparative. There is an expectancy, apekshika, apekshikam antaratvam, and similar, this is one way to interpret it. There are two ways, athava, there will be athava mentioned, and thereby the example and the exemplified connection will be made. We'll see more in the next part. आम्नायन्तिक संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्म ज्योति उपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद.